Most people think that Ediacaran organisms were fairly small, and that's true. We get this tiny little creature here that's shaped like an anchor called Parvancarina, and that means small anchor. And there are a few other normal-sized creatures. Here's Yorgia. Down on this corner we have an organism called Rugoconites. There are these bead-like structures called Funicia, and a few other creatures on the surface. Well, this particular specimen is important because it features an almost complete individual of Dickinsonia. We call this D-Rex. This is really the king of Dickinsonia. It's Dickinsonia Rex because it's perhaps one of the largest Ediacaran organisms that's ever been found. It's pretty much the size of a bath towel. And we see that it's made up of many modules. They look like segments, because at the what we think is the front end of the creature, the segments are at their largest, and when you go to the back end of the creature, they're very, very small. It's been a little distorted and folded here, but on other specimens we can see that that's the place where this creature grows from. It adds segments at the back end, and then during life it not only adds segments, but all of the segments expand and grow. So it grows in almost all directions at once. And when we look at the edge of Dickinsonia rex, we can see the folded over segments, which are no more than quarter of an inch thick, maybe 5 to 10 millimeters thick. That suggests that this whole sheep-like creature was no more than about a quarter of an inch or 5 millimeters thick. So how would a creature like that survive on the seafloor? If there was a piece of organic tissue like this lying on the seafloor today, it'd be eaten within minutes by a fish or a crab or some other predator. And that's the thing. In the Ediacaran seafloors, we find no evidence of any creature eating any other creature. This is probably the only time in the history of large organisms and large animals on Earth where there really was no evidence of big predators. There must have been small creatures eating other small creatures, but we see nothing at this size. Otherwise, this would have been lunch for some other predator.